Yeah, well, it takes a while. Trade negotiations and these kind of tensions, they are easy to raise, but they are very tough to scale back. There's a lot of politics and involved in all this. I think the way forward is to find different channels, and those channels will pop up in different ways. So clearly bilateral is a way forward.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, what examples do you have?
Yeah, bilateral is clearly a way forward, but there are also other ways of having conversations regionally, or in the case of the WTO, a more multilateral format, because that allows for different perspectives in the conversation. If it's strictly bilateral, it's often a win-lose situation. I win, you lose, or this is good for you, this is bad for me. When you have a more open conversation with more countries involved, you tend to have a more productive, a more cooperative conversation. But it's also difficult.
I think President Trump would argue the opposite, because he's been arguing that the WTO and other multilateral organizations don't seem to be equipped or effective enough in trying to deal with a country that is seen as breaching the spirit of the global trading system. So how do you do that? How do you make sure that everybody is abiding by the laws?
Like I said, you cannot exclude any channel. So bilaterals, yes, absolutely, it's important. Bilaterals are usually good if you are trying to gain market access. If you're negotiating market access and or a trade deal, bilaterally it's easier for sure, and more effective, it's quicker. But if you are dealing with the kind of tensions that we have now, it's tough to do it on a bilateral format because there are more countries involved.
So if it means then that having more countries involved, making sure that it is multilateral, then does that mean reforms within the WTO, try to change the system? And if so, what kind of reforms would you recommend?
It's not by accident that people are talking about WTO reform today. And I think one of the reasons why that is there is an opportunity to do things in the WTO that would be very difficult to do bilaterally. For example, if we're talking about revamping or strengthening intellectual property rights and laws, you don't do it bilaterally. You have to have a conversation with other countries because this is by nature a multilateral conversation. It doesn't mean that you have to have 164 members of the WTO on board, but you need to have a significant number of partners playing this game. And I think that right now there is appetite for that.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.